let's go through an example of parametric vector form. So this is example 3 on page 45 of the textbook. I'm just going to add a couple of extra details. So suppose we want to describe the solutions of AX equals B in parametric vector form, where A is this matrix given here, 3, 5, negative 4, negative 3, negative 2, 4, 6, 1, negative 8, and B is the column vector 7, negative 1, negative 4. The first step is we're going to row reduce the associated augmented matrix. Now I can get that augmented matrix by jamming together the coefficient matrix A and this column vector B. So the first step of row reduction, or Gaussian elimination, I'm going to take that pivot, I put a red box around it here, this 3, and I'm going to use that to kill off all the entries below. So I can get rid of the negative 3 in row 2 by replacing row 2 with row 2 plus row 1. That doesn't change the first row. It changes the second row to 0, 3, 0, 6. And now to get rid of the 6 in the third row, I'm going to replace row 3 with row 3 minus 2 row 1. And that gives me 0, negative 9, 0, negative 18. Okay? And then I move on to the next column. So the next column, I have this 3, which I'm going to turn into a pivot. I'm going to use it to kill off the entries below, so this negative 9. And I can achieve that by replacing row 3 with row 3 plus 3 row 2. So the first two rows stay the same, and the last row becomes all zeros. And I notice now, when I put boxes around my pivots, that the matrix is now in echelon form. The fact that the rightmost column is not a pivot column tells me, using the existence and uniqueness theorem, that this linear system has a solution. I'm going to continue row reducing to put it into reduced echelon form so that I can better see what the solution is. So I start with the rightmost pivot, which is this 3. I'm going to turn it into a 1 by multiplying row 2 by 1/3. The first row and the third row stay the same, and the second row becomes 0, 1, 0, 2. Now, I'm going to use this 1 that I've created and kill off all the entries above. So in this case, it's a 5. I can achieve that by replacing row 1 with row 1 minus 5 row 2. The third row stays the same, the second row stays the same, and the first row becomes 3, 0, negative 4, negative 3. And now I'm going to turn to the next pivot, which is a 3. I can turn it into a 1 by dividing row 1 by 3. And I get 1, 0, negative 4 thirds, negative 1 in the first row, and the second two rows stay the same. And now this is in reduced echelon form, and I notice that the first two columns are pivot columns, which tells me x1 and x2 are basic variables. The last column, the third column, is a non-pivot column, so it tells me x3 is free. So now let me just copy that matrix over again. And I'm going to try to solve. Well, x3 is free, so I call it t for some parameter t, a real number. And I see that x2 has to equal 2, and x1 is negative 1 plus 4/3 t. If I want to write this in parametric vector form, I'm going to say x is equal to t times. Well, now I need to grab all the coefficients that have a t on them. And so this is the 4/3, an implicit 0 t there for x2, and a 1 times t for x3. So I'm going to grab the coefficients 4/3, 0, 1. Plus, well, now I'm going to grab all the coefficients that don't have t on them. And so this is a negative 1, 2, and an implicit plus 0. And so in parametric vector form, the solution is x is equal to t times 4/3, 0, 1, plus negative 1, 2, 0.